There are an insane amount of cryptids out there, many of which I want to feature on this channel. There are well-known cryptids, such as the Loch Ness Monster, Bigfoot, and Mothman, and then there are lesser-known ones, such as the Popelik Monster, Loveland Frog, and the Wood Booger being amongst one of my favorites, just because of the name. Talking about lesser-known cryptids has always been fun to me, because let's face it, 90% of cryptids in general, whether they're popular or not, are fake, and the proof out there is always funny. For example, think in your head for a second of what is in this picture. You done yet? Well, it's a real-life mermaid, and it's obviously fake. The best part of it is that it was created by sewing a dead monkey and a dead fish together. To me, it's hilarious to think that some people are willing to go such lengths to fake something as insignificant as a fake animal, but I guess some people just seek attention for a living. But this brings us to the topic of sort of obscure and pretty much disproven cryptids. So today, we're gonna dive into the story of the Mongolian Deathworm. Whoever coined the name Mongolian Deathworm deserves an award for creating such a badass name. And then you got Wood Booger, Owlman, Skunk Ape. But like I said, the Deathworm is a little more on the obscure side, so by the end of this video you will essentially know everything about this thing. With all that out of the way, let's jump into the weird history of the legend that is known as the Mongolian Deathworm. Real quick, before I go over all the evidence, proof, and descriptions of the Mongolian Deathworm, I wanted to just mention how disappointed I was by the end of this, because I didn't know what the Mongolian Deathworm was before this, and I got kind of excited. It sounded really cool, and all it is a 2-foot long disappointment rod, I guess. It really ruined it for me, but anyway, here goes nothing. To put it simply, the Mongolian Deathworm looks like a sausage that could kill anyone instantly just through touch. Or at least that's what Mongolian Prime Minister Damdin Bazar said, according to American explorer and director of the American Museum of Natural History, Roy Chapman Andrews. Of course, like many, Andrews doubted the existence of such a beast, but still published it in two of his books. This behemoth of a worm is said to wiggle around both the western and southern Gobi. Due to the sheer size of this absolute unit, which is about 2 feet long, it is said that when the worm travels underground, he causes waves on the sand above the surface. The death part of the worm's name comes from it being able to kill just about anything at a distance. Some believe it kills by spraying venom, some think it's an electric discharge, and some just think it simply has psychic powers that makes you just sort of die. And I would love to believe that there's a gigantic psychic sausage worm that could kill you simply by looking at your direction, but for some strange reason, I find it hard to believe. Anyway, there has been more investigations into the Mongolian Deathworm than I would like to admit, and surprisingly, every single one turned up with absolutely no evidence. Let's look at the investigations chronologically. In 1990 to 1992, sorry if I get any of these names wrong by the way, Ivan Makarol, a Czech cryptozoologist, author, and explorer who passed away in 2013, led small groups of people into the Gobi Desert. Their goal was to find themselves the elusive Mongolian death worm. Shockingly, they did not end up finding their worm. Yes, I know, it's a shame. But all joking aside, though, I have to give Ivan Makarol credit for his work. He was inspired by Frank Herbert's novel, Dune. And for context, in Dune, there was a huge sandworm that could be lured to the surface using rhythmic tapping. So Ivan, using his big old brain, he did this exact thing, but he included small explosives just in case the worms were farther in the earth than they thought. It didn't work. The next investigation, yes, that was it for the last one, came in 2005. Richard Freeman of the Center of 14 Zoology, which is an organization dedicated to cryptozoology, conducted a less exciting search. Richard Freeman took a team of 4 men from the CFZ, Center of 14 Zoology, And that's just all I could find about it, other than that there's a documentary called The Lair of the Red Worm. And honestly, I tried watching it for myself, and I mean no ill intent for the crew, director, and the hard work that went into it. But when I say it was boring, it was really boring. It was about an hour and a half of the crew getting super vague accounts of people who said they may have saw the worm, and some people saying they saw someone or knew someone that said they saw someone or knew someone that said they knew someone who saw the worm. It's like that situation, like, oh, I know a guy who knows a guy who owns a dog who's owned by, you know, or whatever. And it was just that. And at the same time, I fell asleep like 5 minutes into it, and maybe they found the worm.
1 hour later.
Nope, they did not find the worm. In 2006 to 2007, the television series Destination Truth had an episode called Haunted Island and Devil Worm, where they go to the Gobi Desert to hunt for our worm. You could sort of guess what happened, and this is pretty unrelated, but I remember watching Destination Truth, and because I was so young, I believed every single word that came through that TV. But anyways, lastly, New Zealand television entertainment reporter David Ferrier took part of an expedition in 2009 and left empty-handed once more. I think the most shocking part of literally all of this to me is the fact that I already knew who David Ferrier was. He was somehow related to the Mongolian Deathworm. And for those who do not know, he made a super good documentary called Tickled. I completely recommend it, but I digress. Although Ferrier left empty-handed, he conducted interviews with the locals who claimed to have seen the worm, and he even found out that the sightings peaked in 1950. Many times, there aren't really conclusions to these type of things. Sometimes people just stopped seeing them, and sometimes people constantly keep making excuses as to why they can't seem to get a good picture, and it always happens to be super blurry. Like, come on. What are these? Are these really what we have to go on? This is supposed to prove to me that Bigfoot is real? Like, come on. But anyway, in my opinion, the Mongolian Deathworm is actually already solved. And it has been for a while now. Sorry to burst your Deathworm bubble, but it's just a worm lizard. Richard Freeman, the guy who made the super boring documentary, even mentioned that it likely does not exist. And it was just a case of mistaken sightings. In 1983, researchers showed locals who have said they saw the Deathworm the Tartar sand boa, and they confirmed that it was exactly what they saw. I'm not saying this is the only time we can listen to the locals, but considering this is the only time we heard a local say, yep, that looks like it, I feel like we can trust it a little more. That's about it for this one. Like I said, there's not really much to it because it was kind of easily disproven. There wasn't that much substance to it. And I'm gonna rant a little about cryptids in modern day or whatever, but it's so hard to believe any of them are true anymore. Almost everyone has a camera capable of taking high definition pictures, recording devices, and whatnot, but there's still nothing for just about any cryptid. I'm not saying you shouldn't believe in any of them, I'm just saying it's so demoralizing in a way, how you can't really believe anything, and I'm not complaining because that just shows how much technology progressed. It's just, I don't know, it kind of sucks. It kind of takes away the excitement and mystery out of the world in general. Or it could all be a government conspiracy and they're hiding Bigfoot right under our nose. Yeah, that could be it. Thank you for joining me for this one. I'm a little sick, so sorry if it made this video suck or something. If you have any suggestions and whatnot, leave them in the comments. Like, subscribe, all that stuff, I guess. Thank you for watching.